everyone. Okay, today I'm going to deconstruct Ben, sung by young Michael Jackson before his voice changed. So good. Such a great musician. Such a great tone. Just amazing that this young kid had, like, a pop hit on the radio. It's just amazing. Okay, so this song is from, right now, it's in Disaster. What? Disaster is a 1970s disaster movie musical with, you know, all those disasters, earthquake, tidal wave, killer bees, piranhas, sharks. And I wrote it with my friend Jack Plotnick, and a lot of the songs that are in the show are in it because we're obsessed with them. Ben, I've always been obsessed with, so I purposely made these two twins in the show, Lisa, that's Lisa right there, played by Jonah Verdon, Lisa and her twin brother, Ben. And Ben passes out because he has diabetes. You know, like, don't kids always have diseases in those movies? Passes out, Lisa has to rescue Ben. So first she sings He Ain't Heavy, he's my brother, because she's carrying him, and then she sings Ben. Okay, now why am I obsessed with the song? So many things. So let's start from the beginning. I love the downbeat. Boom. Dun, 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 dun. I don't know what the boom sound is. It's so cool. It actually reminds me a little bit of, remember in Sweet Dreams, the downbeat? Boom, 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 boom. But it's like the same weird boom sound. It's not really a timpani. I don't know what it is. By the way, I'm filming down here because I wanted to use the piano. So just ignore the craziness behind me. I don't know what's happening. I actually had to clean it up. This is clean. All right. So I love the downbeat in Ben. I love that it's just guitar. Bling, bling, bling. So simple. So it has that boom, boom, blink, 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 blink. Then Michael Jackson does Gavin Creel / Barbra Streisand style vibratoing on the consonant. Ben. The two of us need look no more. So I love the Ben. We both found what we were looking for. And he belts the looking for, but then he gives full belt on. With. And it's like gospel vibrato. It's just so belty. I love it. With a friend to call my own. I'll never be alone. Now, these next chords, I literally had to research. It took me so long. I went to Oberlin Conservatory and kind of like went into a higher theory class because I was good at theory, but don't remember the first thing, so I was like, is it an augmented six, German six? Couldn't figure it out, but I think the chord is an augmented seventh chord. I researched it. With a friend to call my own, I'll never be alone. Augmented seventh chord. Why? I researched it. It has the root, the major third, the augmented fifth. This is the fifth. This is the augmented. And the seventh. With a friend to call my own, I'll never be alone. Augmented seventh chord. And you, my friend, will see. Research this. Dominant 7-5-5 chord. Why? Has the root, the major third, the diminished fifth, the minor seventh. Such cool chord. You've got a friend in me. So beautiful. Okay, let's listen to it. Listen to all the above. Here we go. Boom. So what is that boom sound? Listen one more time. Broadened N.
Been the two of us needed no more. We both found what
belted.
We were looking for.
But then full belt.
With the friend to call my own, I'll never be
first chord,
alone.
Augmented.
And you, dominant
7-5-5.
We'll see. You got a friend in.
I want you to hear that also. And you, my friend, will see. I love, it's sort of almost like a riff, and actually in later versions, he goes, and you, my friend, will see. He actually does two different notes, but here he just sort of slides it. It's the beginning of a later on riff, which he does when he gets older. Listen.
With the friend to call my own, I'll never be alone.
Right here.
And you, my friend, will
now,
see.
Now, pure head voice.
You got a friend in.
How sweet is that? That he literally goes into head voice. It's so beautiful.
Alone, and you, my friend, will see. You got a friend in me.
Got a friend in me.
The backup makes me crazy. The crazy octave. You've got a friend, or you've got a friend in. It's just, I find the backup cray cray. All right, let me keep going. Next section. Now, if you get the sheet music for the song, and I think I just printed it out, did I? Yeah. Oh, where the hell did I put it? If you get the music, the second verse just stays the same. Ben, you're always running here and there. You feel you're not modern anywhere. But I think they realized that they can make it much more interesting and barely do any change. They actually make it minor. So instead of Ben, you're always running here and there, they just go Ben. And it suddenly becomes so cool and sort of eerie. And instead of the melody, Ben, you're always, it becomes a minor second. Ben, you're always running here and there. You feel you're not wanted anywhere. Now instead of going, if you ever look, okay, that would change the whole melody. They just go back to major. If you ever look behind, but Michael Jackson does, a la Lynn Winterstellar, the deconstruction I did from Closer Than Ever, when a melody repeats, you change one little note to make it a little sassier. He goes, if you ever look behind and don't like what you find. It's just so great. It's one little change, but it makes it so much more interesting. What else I want to say? Oh, yeah, also, it makes me crazy, the amount of fake instruments nowadays. In the old days, they used these beautiful string sections and beautiful string arrangements. Just listen to how gorgeous it is when the strings enter in that section. If you ever look behind. The beautiful strings are happening. Anything else I want to say about this? Oh, and also, he brings back the head voice. You've got a place to go. Beautiful head voice. All right, here we go. This is the minor verse. So it's all major, and then suddenly. Strings.
If you ever look behind and don't like what you find.
Isn't that great? Hold on, the melody changed. I love it.
If you ever look behind and don't like what you find.
Strings.
There's something you should know.
Head voice. Backup has to stop. Okay, so now the bridge. I used to say I and me. Now it's us, now it's we. A, it's just so pretty. I love the way he sounds. And then the second time through, there's this really beautiful violin line that happens. Okay, so truth be known, when I was a kid, I started studying violin when I was in 11th grade. I basically always been a horrible violinist, but I was obsessed with the violin. And I'd always play along to like pop records. So I was constantly trying to learn, you know, but the kid is not my son. Always trying to play that along with Billie Jean. That's how I funked out, by playing my violin along with Billie Jean. So anyway, in honor of my childhood, I'm going to try to play the violin line during Ben, because it's such a beautiful line. Okay, here we go. Hold on. Try it. I literally have a violin with me. Okay, I used to say, it's so belted. Here he goes. That's not how great it sounds.
I used to say.
Anybody? Nobody. Nobody. But it's so pretty. I wish I could play it well. Okay, the final section. Ben, most people would turn you away. What I love also, by the way, is the violin goes, da 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 da. Now it's we da da. Transfers to the cello line. Ba da ba da. Listen how beautiful it is when the cellos come in. Ba da. When he's singing, Ben, you're always running here and there. You feel you're not wanted. Now he takes a breath. Anywhere. Why? Because two amazing things happen. First one to the melody. Ba da 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 da. The melody goes up a third. They don't see you as I. Actually, I'm singing the wrong lyric. Sorry. Ben, most people would turn you away. I don't listen to a word they say. Melody goes up. They don't see you as I. It's so exciting because you think it's going to go one way, but it actually goes higher. So listen to the chords, by the way. They don't see you as I do. I wish they would try to. Isn't that cool? I'm sure they'd think. Oh, here's a cool chord. Think again. That's a D-flat augmented, if they had a friend like Ben. But what I was going to say about the not breathing, he does, not an elision, a liaison. He liaises to the high C. So he goes, most people turn you away. I don't listen to a word they say. They don't see my... So pretty and so musical. I don't know. Like, did a music director tell him that? Or just... I'm sure he was just infused with music and he just knew to just connect in an opera. It's so exciting. And what I also love just about the song, the very, very end, is that it actually ends. So many songs back in the 70s would have been like, if they had a friend like Ben, and it would just kind of fade out. I hate fade outs. I love that it actually literally ends. Okay, let's listen to this in the final section. So don't forget, it's the cello, and then it's the high note, the melody change, not breathing before it, and then the song actually ends. Delicious. Here we go. Cello.
I don't listen to a word they say.
Here we go. Time, come on, just for that high note. It's so exciting.
Don't listen to a word they say. They don't see you as I do. I wish they were trying to. I'm sure they'd think again if they had been like me.